Hi, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making doughnut. It's going to be an eggless version. Making doughnut in your own home kitchen is very easy and doughnuts are best when they are served warm. So make these doughnuts anytime you crave for. Make fresh and enjoy with all kinds of toppings, coconut nuts, or sprinkle some colorful candies. So let's start. The first thing I'm going to prepare is my yeast mixture to knead my dough. Here I have the 1 cup of milk. I'm going to warm it up into the microwave. Here I have the rapid rise yeast and my milk is lukewarm. So I'm going to add my yeast into this bowl here. Here I have the 1 tablespoon of sugar. Mix it and leave it on the counter to rise. Alright, so the yeast mixture is ready and now I'm going to work on my flours. Now for this recipe I use 1 cup of wheat flour and 1 cup of plain flour, the all-purpose flour. You can use either only one or you can use the combination of both. You can only make with the wheat flour as well. So let's start making the dough first. Here I have 1 cup of all-purpose flour and 1 cup of wheat flour. 1/3 cup of sugar, 1 teaspoon salt. Here I have a 3 tablespoon of butter and it's a room temperature. I'm going to mix this dry ingredients first very well. Make sure that you mix good all purpose and wheat flour. Alright, this is good. Now let's check on our yeast mixture. Look at this. It has risen. Nice. This is how you want. So this is the sign of freshness of yeast. Make sure that your yeast is good. Now to this I'm going to add this butter. Even though this is melted a little bit, when I add into the warm milk it's gonna melt and mix well. And to this I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Just going to eyeball here. Now here I have my flour again. Now I'm ready to mix this yeast mixture and knead the dough. Add slowly. If you need more liquid, you can use regular water. Smells vanilla here. Nice. Now the dough will be sticky, but that's okay. So you need a dough like this. Look at this, it's very stiffy, but this is okay. Now onto the counter, dust all-purpose flour and take your dough and knead this dough very well till it becomes soft. This is very important that you knead your dough almost 6 to 8 minutes with as much flour as you need. Keep kneading the dough with your soft hand. After some time you will notice that it won't stick to your hand anymore. Now do you see this dough? It doesn't stick anymore. Look at this. And this is how you want now. And when you poke your finger, it should not bounce back. Look at this. Now here I have this bowl and into this bowl I'm going to spray this butter flavor spray. And put this dough here and let it rise. Cover it and let it rise for 1/2 hour. Okay, the dough has been resting on a counter for 1/2 hour. It looks great now. It has risen nicely, almost looks triple in quantity. Let's check the dough and look at this. It has got double, actually triple, I should say that. And it's good. And now it's time to have fun, right Drew? We're going to roll it and we're going to make the rolls now.
What is that good smell?
Oh, that's the dough. It's a vanilla extract. Smells good, huh? I have here the dry flour and dough is ready, so I'm going to roll now. Here I have the dough and I'm going to dust the counter with the little bit of flour on the top on the rolling pin. and roll. 1/4 inch thick. You don't need to have the good shape here, so don't worry. You can keep this dough into the refrigerator, and whenever you wish, you can make the warm doughnut. I'm going to roll 1/4 inch thick to cut my doughnut, and this is perfect. And I have here very old fashioned doughnut cutter. My mother-in-law, she's been using for years, and now I'm using it, so it looks kind of bad, but does the great job for me. And you can make as many as you can from this rolled circle. Once I cut my doughnut, I'm going to put them into this tray here, and I'm going to let them rise again. So I'm going to spray with the butter spray the whole tray, and then cut doughnut, and I'm going to cut as many as I can. Look at this. Now I also keep this one. They become kind of bite-sized doughnut. Nice. You can take away the dough like this, and you can actually make again, you can use this dough and make more doughnuts out of it. I'm done cutting all my doughnuts, and now I'm going to let it rise for another 1/2 hour. It's very important to let them rise before you start frying. While doughnut is rising, I'm going to prepare the sugar glaze. Here I have the 2 tablespoons of room temperature butter. You need to have the melted butter actually. So I'm going to melt this little bit. And here I have the 1 cup of icing sugar. And you will need some more milk or water. Just a couple of tablespoons. In this butter here, the melted butter, I'm going to add sugar. Mix well. Mix it well so you know how much water you need, or milk if you're adding milk. Before that, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. So this looks perfect. Now add water. I have the warm water. I warm it into the microwave a little bit. Just a little bit of more water. Now it's good. Now we can even do like this. This is how you want. My doughnut has risen nice now, and let me show you. And my oil is heating up here to fry my doughnuts. And there are 2 ways you can glaze these doughnuts. You can just prepare the simple sugar glaze, or you can make the syrup, and then you can dip into the syrup. And look at this, it has got double now. They were only 1/4 inch thick, and now they're almost 1 inch. For baking option, bake your doughnut at 400 degrees Fahrenheit or 200 degrees Celsius for about 10 to 12 minutes. In the beginning, heat your oil on a medium heat, and then bring down the temperature when you fry them, because we want to fry them at the low temperature. Oil seems to be ready. Take a very small size of dough and try. If the dough come on the top right away, then it's done. It's not done yet. My oil is ready, and I'm going to put 1 doughnut. Actually, I can put 2 easily. And fry them to golden brown on a low temperature now. Do you see the color, how it changes the color because of the sugar that we added? Nice golden brown color. And this is the perfect color. So they are ready to come out. Look at them. You can see that they have puffed up nice as well. And bring them down onto the paper towel. Now, while the doughnuts are warm at that point, you can, the one mixture that the glaze, the sugar glaze that we prepared, I'm going to dip them. Warm up your sugar glaze if you need to. And then put them onto the tray. Here I have my bite-sized doughnuts. I'm going to dip them well and bring them down onto the plate. I'm done with all my doughnuts. Look at them, they look so yummy. My doughnuts are ready. They look good. It's glazing a lot. It's just shining. I'm going to give it a bite. And when you break, you can see that, you know, very soft inside. They are best when they're warm. Here I'm going to glaze with baking chocolate. I have melted into the microwave. If it gets hard, then you can add a little bit of oil. That's a just tip to share with you. And I'm ready to glaze my doughnut. Dip. Just like that. And look at this. And now you can sprinkle, if you want to sprinkle some stuff on there. You can sprinkle right away when it's loose. You can just sprinkle the colorful sprinkle on the top like that. So I'm going to dip some of my doughnut, and I'm going to keep some of them. Like, here is the chocolate dip doughnut, and then put it on the tray. Now I'm going to sprinkle the chocolate one. Here I have some with the sprinkle. Here I have the coconut. I sprinkle some coconut. Look at this doughnut now, yummy. So this was all about the eggless doughnut. Thank you for watching, and I will see you real soon with the next great recipe.